Mr. Secretary, good afternoon, and thank you so much for joining
us, sir. Good afternoon.
Well, some have said that securing vaccine supply is a matter of national security. How does the Philippines stand to benefit from developing our own vaccines? And why wait until 2022, sir? Why can't we produce our own vaccines now?
There are actually a number of things that are involved here. If you want immediate vaccine production, the only way that we can do is to have what we call a fill and finish approach. That means we have to import in bulk the materials that are to be injected, to be and then you put them in the vials that will be needed for the vaccination. Even that will still need a certain time to prepare. First of all, the agreements between the Filipino company involved and the vaccine developer from outside has to be facilitated and consummated, and then they have to prepare the facilities for the fill and finish, and then that has to be subjected also to the usual quality and standards check by our FDA. So we are now in the second quarter of the year, and so the estimate is that the shortest time that we can have that is 2022. But the other thing, of course, is that either these local companies in partnership with the foreign vaccine developers who will do the fill and finish approach here can actually start to proceed already to the full-fledged vaccine production, meaning to say they will produce the vaccine here from the beginning, and then they will have to finish up to the end until they are already in the vials that are needed. But that would also require a transfer of technology, because we do not have our own technology yet. And that's the reason why we are pushing for the creation of the Virology Science and Technology Institute of the Philippines, because the vaccine development will be done there. Our idea of this Virology Science Technology Institute is that this will be the research and development arm of our country to do studies on viruses. That's why the name is virology. And then the ultimate goal is to produce the products, whether it is in the form of vaccines or drugs, okay, that cure, or diagnostic kits that will be needed. And this institute actually is not focusing only on viruses that attack humans, but the proposal is to include also the study of viruses that attack animals and also our plants or crops, because we have problems on virus attacks. For example, the ASF now, it's a virus problem, and even those virus that attack our coconut, our abaca, these are all virus that we have to address. So that is the longer-term solution. To set up that Virology Science and Technology Institute will take at least 2 years to have it operational, and that is when we can produce a look into the development of our own vaccines. So the short term is that of, local companies partnering with the foreign companies for the technology. The short term really is the fill and finish. Okay, the medium term is to do the vaccine production here, but still dependent on the technology of the vaccine developer from abroad. But the longer term is the becoming a vaccine self-reliant Philippines, is to have that Virology Science and Technology Institute for the development of vaccines, drugs, and diagnostic kits, and then to transfer the technology for mass production. So we distinguish between the vaccine development, the production, the mass production of vaccines, and of course the third component there is the procurement by government, because we need a market. Okay, in terms of population, we are big, and so we think that we can actually have our own. And we looked at the models from our neighbors. We see that, for example, in India, they have a research and development institute similar to our Virology Science Technology Institute. Then they have a separate corporation for the vaccine production. And then they also have partnerships. And of course, they have the private companies doing their own production. And so this can all be possible. And so we proposed a roadmap that has a short-term component, a medium-term component, and a long-term component. So the short-term is has started already, 2020. We started negotiations up to 2023. And then we have, of course, medium-term up to 2025. And we are talking of up to 2029 for the long-term. Mm-hmm. And so this is the scenario that we have.
Right, certainly a lofty idea, and supposedly we have the Filipino scientists for it. We know you can't share with us who the potential local vaccine manufacturers are. India had reportedly signified interest to partner with a local manufacturer. Is that correct? Can you share with us how aggressive they've been with plans to produce vaccines locally?
I'll just describe to you. Let me just label them from Company A to Company F, because there are six in different stages.
And we're showing also the graphics for those companies, sir.
I can just mention the company, nationality of the company with whom they want to partner. Okay, mm-hmm. So Company A actually is a distributor of a South Korean company, mm-hmm. and so they are now, this South Korean company is in talks with two companies here for a joint venture, and they're also talking with our National Development Corporation, which is our government corporation, for possible partnerships. Company B, actually, I believe this is a Filipino company that has extensive facilities, and they want a partner that manufactures a wide range of vaccines. No, so this could be a company that produces all that we need, from the vaccines for rubella, polio, HIV, TB, COVID, and other non-COVID diseases.
If I might ask you at this point, sir, if they are already producing vaccines, this company B, why would it take so much longer just for us, for them, to be able to produce more vaccines? If I understand correctly, we're not developing vaccines from scratch. We are just manufacturing existing approved formulas for the vaccine. Is that correct?
I don't think they have already manufacturing vaccines. They are a pharmaceutical company, but not a vaccine producer yet.
I see. Okay.
Okay. So, but that would be a big plus if you have already a facility for pharmaceutical production, for drug production. That would probably be easier than somebody or a company that does not have anything yet at the moment. Okay, so Company C, on the other hand, does not state here which partner they have, but they want to immediately go into local vaccine manufacturing with a fill and finish facility. So this is the short term. Okay, so they will just get the raw material from abroad, fill and finish, and then distribute. Company D is talking with a German developer. Okay, and they're also talking with our DTI through our Board of Investments and the National Development Corporation, because they're willing to partner with government. Company E is the Chinese vaccine producer partner. Okay, so vaccine producer, of course, is interested in local manufacturing here. And again, they're also talking with our DTI through the Board of Investments and the National Development Corporation so that they can fast track their plans. And lastly, Company F is still looking for a partner, but I do believe they are looking for a US-based company. Okay, so they intend initially to do a fill and finish, but convert into a full-fledged vaccine manufacturing later on. We started with the DOST taking care of this, because in the past we were heading the subtechnical working group on vaccine development until there was a reorganization when we have a vaccine SAR, and our role has been to focus on vaccine evaluation and selection. And so now DTI, okay, is taking the lead in the negotiations with the prospective vaccine developers who will be operating here in our country.
Talk about the DTI. Apart from the 5 to 6 years of income tax holiday and preferential treatment in biddings, what would the foreign developers of vaccines need, supposedly from the DOST, to choose the Philippines as its vaccine manufacturing hub? And is the Philippine government willing to give them all this?
Well, we have existing laws on incentives for prepared companies and for prepared areas of investments. And but maybe there will be a need for additional incentives in this case. Okay. I think the idea now is to have a certain specific location where the vaccine producers can locate altogether.
All right. Science and Technology Secretary Fortunato de la Peña, thank you so much for sharing your information with us, and we appreciate the updates.
Okay. Okay. We have other developments, but these are the ones on vaccines. Thank you.
Understood. Thank you so much, and stay safe, sir.